Hi guys and girls, I am René, better known as the Wacko Online, founder of Poker Ambition, where we provide you with what you want and what you need in order to excel as a poker player. And in this video, I will be introducing our program, The Mechanics of Poker. And I want to share with you guys our objective for this program, which is to change the way that you currently approach poker. Now, I'm not here to tell you to change what you do. We will not tell you to play a different strategy, c-bet more, c-bet less. We're also not going to overload you with GTO solutions in every spot of the tree or population data exploits to memorize. No, guys. The goal is to change your philosophy, to change your approach towards strategy, learning, and to being a poker player, okay? Change your approach, change the way you think, and give you a new way of looking at the game. Now, in order to do that, this program will focus on the mechanics of poker success instead of only telling you the outcome, so the what to do. The number one pain point for the poker population is that they're not understanding the why. Why does a solver play a certain strategy? Why does the population have a certain leak? Why does this play actually work? In general, there's a lack of understanding how poker really works and how EV is generated. Now, this is because most of the poker content out there tells you what to do. They will tell you how to play a certain strategy, but they kind of forget to tell you why. They actually forget to explain you how poker really works. Now, this way you won't learn poker at a deeper level. It will be very limited to your specific game type. It would probably get outdated, and most of all, it would get enormous, impossible for you to memorize and let alone execute consistently at the tables. Whereas if we focus more on the mechanics of poker, so how things work, what our objective is while playing a hand, and why we approach or play a certain strategy, you will see that these are all based on a bunch of concepts that basically come back every time you play in every sort of situation. And in this program, we will focus on those concepts. Now, who is this program for? For everyone. If you play MTTs, cash games, sit and goes, live or online, this program is for you, okay? Because of the often used what-based learning, other programs, they need to focus on MTTs or cash games. Whereas if we focus on why, so concepts and ways of thinking, we can then use cash games and MTT examples to see how this would translate into a strategy into practice. So no matter what game you play, which limits, or how far you are in your poker career, this knowledge can be applied anywhere and by everyone. This program is for all poker players. Because no matter your level, success in poker comes down to the same things, okay? When we explain poker and how to get more success in your poker career to any level of player, we keep on coming back to the same things. The only thing that changes is the terminology we use and the depth of nuances we would get into. And I noticed that a trend in poker is for players to often think about the wrong things. I sometimes see players explaining a hand using a lot of terms that I've never even heard about before actually butchering the hand based on some basic fundamentals about how EV is generated. They are thinking about the wrong things in the wrong order of importance. And we are here to prioritize and structure what it is you need to think about in order to make higher EV decisions and what is really important in order to succeed as a poker player. Now, most poker coaching companies or products would stop here as their goal was to explain you what you wanted, which was to play a certain game, or in our case, to play poker, okay? But we care about your progress and we want you to succeed. There's a very big difference between knowing and consistently executing. Because as we both know, sometimes poker feels like this. We got the whiskey, the aces, the chips, the cigars, we are winning money, life is good. But unfortunately, being very good technically and everything that we've just explained to you doesn't always necessarily translate into high winnings at the poker tables. Because unfortunately, what we know doesn't always come out. We don't always play as well as we would like to, or as much as we would like to, or put in the effort that we would like to see from ourselves. We are not necessarily always the professional that we would like to be, which can be very frustrating. And it drives us crazy. And you are not alone because the people around you experience exactly the same thing. Now, what differentiates the best from the rest is their ability to consistently execute what they know at the poker tables. They know how to convert their technical knowledge into money in their account. So how do we do that? Mental game and performance. The steps to converting your technical knowledge into bling, bling, bling dollars. In our mindset and performance section, ex-high stakes sit and go player turned mindset and performance coach Adam Carmichael will teach you how to convert and execute that knowledge better and more consistently to get the most out of your poker career. Now, all of that is great. Everyone wants this, of course, but you might still be wondering, well, why you? Why you, Mr. Wacko and Adam? Why poker ambition? Well, I was stuck and struggling at mid-stakes for over 5 years. Adam experienced the same. We were stuck until we changed our approach towards playing poker and being a poker professional. Basically, we started shaping our philosophy. Adam, with that philosophy, managed to break through to high-stakes sit-and-goes. And as for me, after staying stuck at mid-stakes, from 2016 onwards, I managed to break through mid-stakes, started to play high-stakes poker. And here we can see my results since then. Now, we're not smarter than you guys. Me and Adam are not smarter than you. We are also not special, and it was definitely also not talent that got us there. If it was all that, we wouldn't have had to struggle for all those years. Because the reality is, guys, that we are just like you. Now, I was sure that this was actually teachable to others. And in order to prove that, we started the Poker Ambition CFP program. So basically what we did, we got a bunch of students playing between 50 and 200 in hell. And we wanted to see if we could get them to high stakes as well using this philosophy. So this was their starting point when they joined the CFP. And now, 1.5 to 2 years later, guys, I am confidently in saying that it works. Because here we can see the last 3 months results of players in the CFP. And as you can see, they clearly moved up in stakes and increased their win rate. So we got to high stakes. Then we taught them how to get to high stakes. And the good news is that you can be next. Now, I didn't get to the successes alone. I gathered the team around me along the way, guys with which I do a lot of strategy, and I would like to introduce you to them. Explode777, Kempy7, Tunis, Need2Mark3, very good cash game players, Flusu, Poker Kluka, cash game players mainly as well, but had their fair share of tournament successes, I might say. And then Bill Lewinsky and Tino Mulder, which are mainly MTT specialists. Now, when joining the PA club and community, you will find players that are in the same direction as you and that you can form a team with, just like I did, in order to get bigger successes in poker. So you must be very excited now to join the club and to start the program. And you must be wondering, well, how does it all look? Well, why don't I show you?